Hi, I'm Pietro Lepascia. Thank you very much for inviting me. I represent the IID, that is International Institute of Environmental Development, America Latina and Latin America, that is an NGO from Argentina based on Buenos Aires City. So, well, the video shows clearly the importance of nationalization of the water and sanitation services in Buenos Aires. Because since that time, 2006, the public company AESA embarked on an infrastructure expansion plan aimed at providing water and sanitation to the greater Buenos Aires areas. I want to share with you the map, where we have the greatest shortage of services, sanitation service and water service. Just to have an idea, we were working in, we developed an experience with the public company. We call it in Spanish acompañamiento social. That was very difficult to translate in English. And we translated it like social support and awareness raising program. So we are working here in the western area of Great Buenos Aires, where we have the most important shortage in sanitation and water. Around 50% of households have sanitation deficit, and 33% in water. Just to have an idea, this is the area that our public company comprises. City of Buenos Aires and 17 suburban municipalities, that is the metropolitan area of Buenos Aires. About 15 million people live there, so almost 35% of the Argentina population. Public utility is serving a population of almost 10,000 million inhabitants. So since September of 2012, the public company implemented with our organization the social support and awareness raising program in relation to sanitation and infrastructure works. So this is where our main objectives, just to foster the normal technical development of the works, to keep population informed about
I can hear fine.
Yeah, I think so. Not I can shout. So to foster the normal technical development of the works, to keep population informed about work progress, to inform what is important, to inform service availability, and to sensitize people about benefits of sanitation connection. Also because of the neighbors' demands, we also had to develop provide training on the proper sanitation connection and use of the service. So we are talking about sanitation works about 20,000 connections. So, our program was carried out in an associative process. Just an important thing. We didn't have only this object. We have also a challenge that was to build a participative management model useful for the public service and all actors involved. So, it was not easy to connect technical technicians and all
now we can't hear you, sorry.
You can't? Okay. I think I can put it here. It's okay. Here? Now, yes?
Yes.
So, well, we developed this associative process involving public company users, neighborhood communities, social organizations, and local governments. And we develop two big components, a social intervention component and a research component. And, our methodological strategy was structured to the three logical stages in the work execution process, that is, before, during, and afterwards. So in each of these stages we develop a lot of activities, such as meeting, workshops, with neighborhoods, with neighbors, with social institutions, with the company and local municipalities, teams. So, but what I want to point out here is the main feature of our management model. So we develop a flexible and participative approach based on awareness of the diversity of social conditions in each area and taking account the peculiarities of local government also and the different stages of the work process. Because not all areas were identical, so we didn't do the same activities in all areas. So related to that, most activities that was very important for us were built with a bottom-up approach. So we didn't design them beforehand. So devising this bottom-up approach, activities based on neighbors' needs, enable us to have a better impact on households. Just really, we're working with almost 12,000 households seeking to raise their awareness on the benefits and effects of service connection, and with more than 35 social organizations. That was a really good work. And sometimes we went door by door, talking and having meetings with the neighbors. So I want, well, this is my activities. So I want to share with you our management modeling approach. In the upper part, shows the management approach that I have performed until we started our work. But you can see it's just a technical approach. You don't see neighbors there, you can't see social institutions. So in the lower part of the diagram, you can see the inclusion of a social dimension into the management. This model, we propose this model, and we include neighbors, social institutions, leaders, and it was not easy. It seems it's easy, but it was quite difficult to run this model. And the difficulties were at territorial level, I have to say, just with technicians, inspectors, and with the municipal teams. But we are with a technical vision of that. So, just to share with you some example of our work. This service connection study reveals that in zones where we didn't develop any social intervention component, that is the 35%, households ignore that the wards were ready for service connection. So this percentage is much higher, 10 times much higher than in zones where we have done our work. So this, for us, is a proof that social intervention is a way to shorten the gap between works and communities. So the public company made the sanitation infrastructure and was executed, but what about household connection? That was our question. Some part of the company also was worried about effective connection. So trying to know what would people need, if they could correct any difficulties related to that, we conducted a research on Bona. And really, this was a key tool for our work and for starting a public policy discussion with all actors interested in effective sanitation access. So we conducted this survey about 2,000 cases. I'm just presenting one case that in one zone, that is the municipality of Tusango. And, okay. And, well, you can see numbers. So despite the idea of local government and technical teams of AISA that assumed that all houses were connected, when we talked with them, we said, don't worry, all people is connected. We found that 40% of households were not connected to the sanitation system after almost 1 year works were finished. So we found a very big problem here. And in a deeper analysis, not all, we can see also some people more vulnerable than others. So you can see here that the connection rate is 25 higher among owners, than among tenants. So tenants remain in a vulnerable situation because landlords have to do the sanitation connection, but as figure shows, most of them doesn't want to pay for the connection. So we have here 60% of population of tenants, more than 60, without connection to the service. We have also found that connection rate is significantly lower and, in single and two-member households than in three and more members. So we have to focus on this and to work on this. So when we ask main reasons for not connecting, we can see that half the household, the reason is because on economic grounds. But we have also a lot of other reasons that are important to address, such as lack of information regarding the availability of the service, technical difficulties, lack of interest in connecting. So it's a tenant. So we have to address all these problems. So we found four kinds of problems, no? Just those related to the economic cost of the connection, those related to the cost but also resulting from technical uncertainty. They don't know how to do it, with whom, if the work is doing it properly. Those caused by lack of information and interest. And the last one, lack of legal regulations. Well, I think this intersects all the three others. We don't have laws or regulations just to push the landlords or shops or households without any interest to connect. So our research allows us a clear picture of demands. The households and the causes of not connection, and this enables to design strategies and activities for a better impact on effective service connection. So we did a lot of activities trying to improve the connection rate. And the other thing that is quite important for us, for a public policy discussion, is that the finding of the research allow us to put into question the idea of 100% executed work. It is equal at 100% finished work. We don't think that finished its work. We have 40% of the population not connected. So this idea that it's finished and it is okay is prevalent in the mind of technicians of the public company, some of them, and local government teams. And we have started, because we have this results, these findings, we have started to discuss this issue inside public company and with local governments also. Sorry. So, how to bridge the gap of service connection? Yes, they will pick. We don't have the answer, but seems to us that an economic and political discussion on how to improve this right has to be done in terms of regulations, programs, and resources to allocate. Households don't pay anything for sanitation or water expansion work. They pay now just $1 per month, only for the service. And here we have to ask if public utility has to subsidize middle, upper, and upper classes. So part of us think that we don't have to do it. But at least we have to debate on this. I think we need that the public utility has to discuss this point. Also, we need to discuss the role of the local government, yes, in this kind of work. But this, at the moment, the local government role is scarce. The works are fully performed by ISA. There is no regulatory framework that ensures a joint work with the local governments or a clear specification of the type of participation or functions to be carried out by the local government. We have another. I have to finish. Just three things. As conclusions. Yeah. So for us, our experience shows that it's crucial to develop a specific local research, relying on local information, building bottom-up activity information that would enable to adjust programs to improve our intervention work, social work, according to the specific needs of each area. Secondly, trends of effective connection and difficulties for connection show that it's necessary to coordinate actors and resources. And public service has the challenge to devise a joint management framework with the participation of key actors, local government, and social organizations. And at the end, planning works from a comprehensive approach. This means fostering the composition of mixed teams, technical and social teams. We think and we prove that social intervention shortens the gaps between works and communities. So we are in the right way, as the video shows, but we have to be more creative in searching alternatives to involve more actors, to achieve the goal of 100 population connected. Thank you.